fuck Joe without knowing. Do you possess man who is blind and unable to speak with breath to him? Do you know then that the man could both speak and see? All of the crowds were astounded and said, could this be the son of David? When the Pharisees heard this, said, this man drives out demons only by Beelzebul, the ruler of demons. Jesus told them, every kingdom divided against itself is headed for destruction. No city or house divided against itself will stand. If Satan drives out Satan, he is divided against himself. How then would his kingdom stand? And if I drive out demons by Beelzebul, then whom do your sons drive them out? For this reason, he will be your judges. If I drive out demons by the Spirit of God, then the kingdom of God has come among you. can someone enter a strong man's house and steal his possessions unless he first ties up the strong man? Then he can plunder his own. Anyone who is not with me is against me, and anyone who does not gather with me scatters. Let's pray. Father in heaven, your kingdom stands, spreads among the nations, the churches are here, praise your name. Your kingdom is strong. I pray, Lord, that your kingdom remains united. We glorify the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. There's no room for neutrality. Remember last week, no, 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, when I preached in that Matthew 12 at the beginning of the verse. You can't just pick what verses we're going to talk about, the ones people like topic verses. A lot of times people will think of a topic and then look for verses to match that topic. But I believe that we need to take each passage as it comes. Because when people try to pick and choose verses out of context, it changes the meanings of the verses. Instead, I believe that God has written his word perfectly to flow exactly right. God, his word has a perfect plan so that we can learn verses verse by verse. The one that Byron just recently signed, Deuteronomy 29:29, it really touched my heart because, our friend who's recently gone, he talked about Isaiah. God has a perfect plan. But it's from us. And a lot of times we want to look past that view and see what God's plan is. But God has not revealed it to us. God has only revealed Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. There's no vagueness in it. It's clear that we can only go to heaven through Jesus Christ. Do good. On the Sabbath day, do good. On the Lord's day, do good. There's 2 or 3 weeks ago, maybe, that we talked about this verses. On the Sabbath day, it's wrong for you to do things. And they wouldn't allow them to do good. And Jesus said, you can do good on the Sabbath. Continue to heal even on the Sabbath day, and the Pharisees were angry about it. These verses. The demon possessed man. It doesn't say how long that he was blind or unable to speak. You know that the demon came upon him and was not able to see or speak because of it. When Jesus healed him, he was able to see and speak. A few months ago, we talked about Jesus healing someone who was on the boat, and someone who knew he healed, and then he was able to speak. Somehow that demon created the person to not be able to speak. Jesus cast the demon out. People in the crowd were amazed. They say the prophets have talked about the son of David and his arrival. The people in the crowd began to wonder, is he the son of David? But the Pharisees, of course, wanted to deny it. Jesus declared, who else could possibly do those things? The very soon, no, but they're hurt for hurting. They absolutely didn't want to believe what they were saying. So they wanted to say that a demon cast out demons. Even she was sort of like, unbelievable. You know, Kentucky, their state flag, this is what it looks like. You see on the bottom it says, united we stand, divided we fall. Talking about being strong together when we divide, we're no longer strong and we fall apart. I mean, it's obvious this is from the Bible. Kentucky is against Kentucky, then we fall apart. And the same with churches, Christians. If Christians are against Christians, the church will fall apart. Both of us are not good when the church splits. It's feelings. God commands us to love one another. We, of course, have our own options. We don't like someone, but God has commanded us to love. The church is to be united. We must have unity. Without that unity, we fall apart. We pray that we would examine our hearts. Do we love our brothers and sisters? Even if we don't have the same type of backgrounds, the same ideologies, even if our thoughts are different, we must still love each other. Some people say, well, maybe you can just not like them. No. God says we must love them, period. There's no middle ground in this, not. And I thought about this a lot. More now. New membership class. We're thinking about my presentation I did last meeting. I'm talking about church discipline. I'm talking about new members joining. I'm always learning new things. I'm adding new things. I wish I could have added to a first new members classes. I'm always constantly learning new things, always constantly thinking about new things and adding and making it better. I was teaching deaf Bible counselors that we must read the Bible every single day. We must pray every single day. We can't just be la 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 la, no. Well, I know. No. You should. The things that you already know, be able to contemplate them even more. Meditate on them. Meditate on the Word. Not just, oh, I know already and I'm done. No. We need to continually meditate on the Word of God every single day, all throughout our life. You know, we're divided, we fall. Jesus knew what the Pharisees were thinking. The easy read version of the Bible that says it. And Jesus knew what the Pharisees were thinking. And he said to them, every kingdom that fights against itself will be destroyed. America, we are very divided against ourselves. It's a scary thought. When we're divided, it leads to civil war. War, you know, there was a time when America was very strong, standing together. So when divided, we become weak. And it leads to downfall. We pray that the politics will clear up. You know, people seem to think voting and those senators and stuff that are in there for 30 or 40 years has never helped the communities. Why do we continue to vote these people into office? Have you been paying attention to what your senator is doing? Are they doing what they need to be doing for it? If not, pick another senator. It's easy. So many people, they just go and they vote and they don't really research who the people that are voting for. Very simple, we all should be doing that. Pharisees. They're saying that Jesus is under demons. He cast out demons, even though I'm supposed to be a demon. Right? Now they're full, for sure. I'm not so bad if I did it that way. And Jesus said, and he really had them in the ropes. You know, the other Pharisees want to say, demon casting out demons. And Jesus is like, it's impossible. That kingdom apart with the ifs. Okay, so now, hold on to that thought. Let's talk about demons are a real enemy. Now, I don't talk a whole lot about demons myself. I don't want to give them a whole lot of credit because demons are real, yes. And when I clearly explain that, this is, you know, we've seen this is really what demons look like. No, not at all. The artists have put them in, you know, with horns, the pitchfork, ugly, whatever. Yeah, they were project. Okay. What does the devil really look like? There's a verse that tells us. There's no wonder. Satan disguises himself as an angel of light. Oh, and he's really good at deceiving us. Watch out, be careful. The strategists. Two very famous strategists, and I learned this, it was really interesting. Arthur Frogger died. But I love his writing. That explains many things that makes me really think. You don't talk a whole lot about demons. It's important that our views are clear. In some churches, some pastors, they don't even believe that there are demons even more. And some people think that it's closed over with canon. But I don't agree with that, no. There are still demons here today. Yes, the world thinks that demons are made up. They think it's like this. Now, this is not what demons really look like. Okay. When it's a strategy, it is 70. Some people believe there are no more demons out there. But there are demons, there are. And there's a strategy. Or this broad has a good explanation. I want to share with my brothers in Christ that don't believe in demons. I shared with him what R.C. Sproul said. And says, if you don't believe in demons, then the church is no good. Because here's a strategy. Cleverest way he does not exist of believing that he has an equal power with God. There's two things. Either he doesn't exist or that he has an equal power with God. talk about now, being, Satan is being cast into the lake of fire, and having hands to obey God. There's not equality between Satan and God. Some artists, they try to make it so that, you know, Satan, Jesus are arm wrestling. Have you seen that picture? That artist put on, I've seen on Facebook, it's disgusting. You mean he's equal with God or Jesus? No. The answer is no, he's not equal. Earth is from. The church seeks to find a pastor. Okay, people that are 70, 80, they believe there is no demons. There's no Satan. They had good doctrine, but there seemed to be a conflict. As R.C. Pearl, please help us. We're looking for a pastor, and we're trying to find a pastor for the church. Well, first thing said, what is their view of angels? Okay, angels are important. What is their view of Satan is not really any good, but R.C. Pearl said, if they don't believe there's no Satan, then just ignore that person as pastor. Okay. It's easy for us when we sin to blame Satan. Most of the time when we sin, that is from your own wickedness. Okay. Satan is there. Trying to sway you, trying to give you temptation to sin. And very smart. Even smarter than us. However long we've been around, he knows human weakness. He knows our thoughts are weak. And when I learned, I've only been alive for 52 years, and he's been around thousands. Yeah, important for us to constantly study God's word so we can resist the devil and not fall for the traps. Okay, so watch out. Do we believe that he exists? And do we? He's not equal with God. JFK, the president, they just shot. Many people in the interview said, I remember where I am when he died. I remember where he died. And then there are people who remember exactly where they were at that moment when JFK was killed. No, hold on, hold on. People say, oh, Satan. It was a lot on the news. I said, probably was on a seminar at that time. So, there was Satan. The devil did this, the devil did that, blah, 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 blah. Today, 9/11. Yeah, remember where you were when 9/11 happened. I was on vacation. I picked your board on vacation. I remember my son, my daughter, teaching about the tower. What? It's crazy to me that just the teacher know about what happened? When the character auditioned. I remember watching on the mirror and being just done. We saw live that second power be hit. I remember being absolutely done. I'd woken up from a nap. My kids were young, they were being goofy, playing around. I'd taken a nap and saw Manu, the second tower be hit. I remember George Bush. His name, the Access of Evil. The world uses these terms. Satan is yet still there. So, today, 9/11, Memorial Day. It's starting to fade a bit, but most people remember where they were on 9/11 when that day happened. You guys will never forget it, those who were around at that time. Some of you at work, some of you are wherever. I lift you up from the earth, I will draw all people to myself. Now the ruler of this world is cast down. The ruler of this world is Satan. Ephesians 2:2, in which we previously walked according to the ways of this world. It used to be according to the ruler of the power of the air and the spirit now working in disobedience. That's Satan. Ephesians 6:12, for our struggle is not against blood and blood, but against rulers, against authorities, against the cosmic powers of this darkness, against evil spiritual forces in the heavens. Our struggle is against that. The devil is real. Now, there is no neutral ground. Clearly, there are two separate. You have to know which one are you, the kingdom of God or the kingdom of the evil one. The believers are part of the kingdom of God, and those who don't believe are part of the kingdom of the evil one. The setting for today's sermon, and now maybe you guys have forgotten, but I remember very well. The visible and the invisible. The people who are here today are not guaranteed to be part of God's church. Only those who are truly saved, the invisible church. There are people who come to church though and go home after and live in their lives until some folks read the Bible, don't apply it to their lives. And they say, oh, I'm tired, I'm busy, I know I should. But they never really do. That's what we call the visible church. When they die, they still go to hell. Even if they come to church all the time, it's still part of the kingdom of the evil one. Something for us to examine our hearts of. The kingdom has come. It's already here. The Bible says, so if I just drive out demons, I'm a devil. But who do you drive them on? Who are they under? Can Satan cast out demons? I should know about it. And for this reason, your sons will be their judges. I drive out demons by the Spirit of God, then the kingdom of God has come among you. Okay. Jesus has come. His kingdom is here. And instead of his churches, it's his kingdom. It's here, it's not. Jesus warned the Pharisees that he would be judged. Okay? The Pharisees didn't want to accept that Jesus was God. The kingdom had come to be established. The world hates Christians. Now, every Jew, whatever. They hate us. Why? Why do they hate us? This cleverness. Because they know. Because the light judges them. The light allows them. It shows them their sin. They know that judgment is coming to them, that punishment is coming. They want to do everything they can to block out that light. LGBT group, it is a religious group. People don't want to admit it, but it's true. It's a religious group. Atheists, they're a religious group. And many religions have hate for you. Jesus says, wake up, don't miss it. Okay, you're against the kingdom that's here. And Jesus already shown the man that was demon possessed was healed, he could see, he could speak. He showed through all of that miracles that he did, the same thing, it's untrue. The power of God is right there. They didn't want to believe it, they didn't want to accept it. They want to say that he was under Satan. A strong man. This story, the teaching that Jesus makes, this is clear. Okay, makes sense. But how can someone enter a strong man's house and steal his things unless he ties them up? Is it easy? No. The guy that's strong, he'll beat you up before you get in the door. You know, you pass out. But how can I steal something from a strong man's house? First up, gotta take him out, right? Got time up so they can't do anything to me. Then I can steal from them. Okay. Jesus is stronger than Satan. Okay. Remember, Satan had two strategies, that there's no Satan, or that he's equal in power with God. Jesus is stronger than Satan. It's easy. Well, you need to understand. There's no equality. The Pharisees hear this story, and they don't like it. Okay. No room, neutrality. Dangerous is complicit. I said it. and I'm going to bring it forward, in cases of sexual violence, sorry to say I'm not, sexual violence, if you stay neutral, you're choosing the side of the predator. You understand that? I'm going to sign it again. Okay. No one answers for whatever, I'm not going to count. If I see it happen, that I ignore it and I turn away and I don't report, I don't do anything about it. No. I am supporting the rapist. Okay. If I don't do anything about it, the person that's being hurt or whatever, and I did nothing, I want to pretend that I didn't see it. Yeah, I can't speak, but if I close my eyes to it, you know, close my ears, close my mouth to it, if people close their eyes, tie up their hands or whatever, that, and you're supporting the crime. And people that say, oh, I'm not against Jesus, but I don't want to go to church. You're already against Jesus. And people try to say they're neutral. No, you've already chosen Satan. Okay. Let's see. People are saying, oh yeah, I hate Jesus. It's pretty rare. I'm being honest. I see an increase lately, an increase of people who are that bit scary. Long time ago, nobody would say, I mean, very few people would say that they absolutely hate Jesus. People usually say, oh, I don't want to believe in that kind of thing. I'm not really against Jesus or anything, but that's typically what you see most of them. Oh, I don't go to church. I don't believe, but, you know, I don't really want to go to church. You have to tell the blunt truth. They are already against Jews. But Jesus is very clear in his definition. But anyone who is not with me is against me, period. Against me. You can't be in the neutral. You can't be in the middle. I don't really want to be a bother to, no, you're against God. You're against God. Oh, no, not me. I'm neutral. I'm good. I'm a good person. You're against Jesus. And Pharisees, you got, they were holier than holy. They were perfect. They're against Jesus. Yeah, maybe they were more religious than you, but they were still against Jesus. Where did they go? They were going to hell. Jesus made it clear. You're against me, you're going to hell. To anyone who does not gather with me, gather. You hear people just say, I'm just, I believe, I was baptized or whatever. Oh, really? What church are you going to? Oh, I don't know. I've not found one I really like. I've not found one that fits with what I believe. God. Did God say that you're not sharing church with what you believe? No, he says command that that's the love. Love people and love God, that's it. Didn't say we have to find our church that matches us. I'm not more important than everything else. But other people are not good enough for me. He said you will scatter. You must stay with you. this many times, even though I've read it over and over, it catches my attention. Now there's no room to be neutral. There's no room. People who, even though they say they're not against Jesus, they really are. I know I have the guts to tell people that they're really against them. And Jesus very blunt when he said it. He said it straight up. He's a lot more blunt than I am. And now I have trouble doing that. But we need to take this verse and share it. When you get out into the world, your life, and you have to face LGBT, your life. You know, they like to retaliate. Oh, yeah. It's done with the word, family of Jesus. The only way, the only truth, the only life, the only one. They come. Be grateful to him. In other words, you don't believe in man, Jesus, you belong in Satan's kingdom. If you don't follow man, Jesus, you are my enemies. If you are not for man, you are against man. That's the other way that this verse has been said. To make it simple in English, this is it. That's what he's saying. Jesus is the only way. He says he is the way, the truth, and the life. He's the only one. And then, his word is hard. It's not easy at all. And the evangelism today is so soft. Oh, God loves you. Testimony. Come join me at church, please. No. We need to be preaching the truth. And the truth is hard. That's the one. Of course, a lot of current messages bothers me. Would you like to receive Jesus? You would love to believe in him? He will lift up your life. He will make you feel so good about yourself. That's what evangelism is today. That's the way that people evangelize. Oh. Now, the truth is, we are sinners. We are on our way to hell for eternity. We want to get out of that. Believe in Jesus Christ. We cannot do it. We believe in Jesus Christ. And let's go in the church. New members teaching. He says, I will bound my church. Everything belongs to earth will be bound to the earth, and those who belong down to heaven will be bound to heaven. Verse Matthew 6:18. New members will see today that that's a new language. This week, come on. Because before, having overlooked the times of ignorance, God now commands all people everywhere to repent. It's not an option. God, come on. Repent. Come on. Maybe you think heaven is arrogant. That's not my word. This is from the Bible. Okay. Considering ignorance of people, God, come on. All people everywhere. A 360 going back to your old way. Now, 180. Turn around and go in out of the direction. Go opposite to the wall. Okay, towards Jesus. Every person's duties is submit to the Lord of glory. Those who refuse to come to Christ sin grievously against the Son of God and God Himself. In 2 weeks, we're going to talk about ardent, unpardonable, and what that means. Let me preach about that. Refuse to come to the King of Kings. Unpardonable sin. Rebellious sin against the Son of God. And rebellion against God Himself, the King of Judah. I played with you. I beg you not to continue in sin. But to follow Judah. Love God with all your heart, your mind, and your strength and soul. Love your neighbor. If you don't love your neighbor, you're divided. Love your neighbor in unity. That's right. Father in heaven, we thank you for your word. And there's a new place. Piercing is from that your Holy Spirit is here. And this pastor of what is, I've been thinking about it for a week and a half and put it in my heart. And thank you, Lord, for teaching us. And pray that we will look and give our attention to you and to your word. Thank you in Jesus Christ, my name is Brad.